Well, I'm sitting over here on Parchment Farm. Well, I'm sitting over here on Parchment Farm. Well, I'm sitting over here on Parchment Farm, and I ain't never done no man no harm. Well, I'm putting that cotton in an 11-foot sack. Well, I'm putting that cotton in an 11-foot sack. I'm putting that cotton in an 11-foot sack with a 12-gauge shotgun at my back. For the rest of my life, and all I did was shoot my wife. I'm sitting over here on Parchment Farm.
In a Scotia taste right now, I want to talk about Esther's Beauty Salon. And that's right, Esther's Beauty's one of the places Early Bird like to recommend to all the ladies listening in for good grooming. Now, you know, ladies, that your hair is your crowning glory. But if your hair is, if it's not getting the care that it should get, then it doesn't look right. Let me recommend Esther's Beauty Salon, 5 Columbus Avenue, phone circle 781 appointment, or you can walk in. Miss Fitzgerald or Mrs. Dorothy Jennings or your hairstylist there, and they really know what's happening. Now, they're stylists, you know, not just beauticians, you dig? You call Miss Fitzgerald at 264 for an appointment, or at the shop, CI07. That's Esther's Beauty Salon, 555 Columbus Avenue in Boston. I'm sure you'd tell them that Early Bird sent you from WLD. Okay, crazy, baby. We're going to move it some more on the Early Bird Show. Sarah McLaughlin, Richard Otto, currently breaking it up at Big Jim Mellon's Shanty Lounge. If you haven't picked up on what's happening over there, fall by, won't you? I bet you'll dig it. You know, I know that I would dig jazz violin, but you might. And they still won't take care of business at the shanty. Gone by, and there's always a swinging set there for you, and you'll enjoy a little visit at Big Jim Mellon's Shanty Lounge, 71 Washington Street. Make it! All righty.
Yeah, baby, that's that big thing for the contours, and it's called You Can Do It. All right, we sure hope you enjoyed it. Let's see, the time is 22:04. Danny Shays of 291. Always have a swing, always have something swinging going on for you. Go on by and catch my man Rollins leading the puzzles there. Drop on by and say hi to the gang tonight at Danny Shays, Turn Street, Roxbury. Tell them early bird pulled your coat for shopping, okay? Groove there. Moving with some more on the early bird show. I want to talk about the Viking Home Improvement Company now to all the homeowners, because this is, mom and dad, this is important. For $25 a month, your home can be as modern as tomorrow. I'm not kidding you. That old bathroom can be made new. That kitchen can become a modern push-button job. And the cellar will be an extra room or extra playroom, whatever you want it to be. Same thing for the attics or the new dormers. And when you call my sponsor, Viking Home Improvement Company, you're not asking to buy anything. You only want to see. Call CO. The counseling and the planning is free. If you want them to do the job, they use nothing but the highest quality materials. The workmen are experts, and you get a guarantee in writing. That's right, in writing. So learn how you can have home improvements for as little as $25 a month. Call now, won't you? C500, tell them early bird. Get around that if you can, Mommy and Daddy. A good old golden goodie. That Nate Nelson of the Flingos, and I'll be home. 20 Lynn Car Wash, 7th Street, Roxbury, is definitely the place for you to take your automobile, you know. In fact, they wash your car while you wait, inside and out. That address is 20, you know, they salmonize cars, and they clean the upholstery, they steam clean the motors, and they open every day, 6 days a week, from 8 a.m. to 6 p.m., Sundays, May to 2. So be sure to take your car to the Lynn Car Wash, 27th Street, Roxbury. Tell them early bird sent you.
I don't know what that is. It's a photograph of Norman Mailer, who's a very great writer. He donated his ego to the Harvard Medical School for study. And this I can tell you already, this is a centerfold from a magazine we used to call Playboy, which these girls didn't exist in actual life. You know, they were rubberized. You had to blow them up, and then you'd fasten it, and you could spread ointment on them or anything else. I'll just take this, and study it later and give you a full report on it.
Would you tell me exactly what this is?
This is the chattering teeth. And this you would buy at a store and you'd take it to a party if you wanted to get big laughs, and you'd put it down on the coffee table or something, you know, and you'd set it off. And then, you see how funny it is? The teeth chatter. They're plastic.
I am going at this time give to this television and radio audience.
Some of us have a theory that he might once have been a president of the United States, but that he did something horrendous so that all records, everything was wiped out about him. There is nothing in history books. There are no pictures on stamps. Money.
Yes, he actually was president of the United States, but I know that whenever he used to leave the White House, the Secret Service used to count the silverware.
Thank you very much, Jimmy. From the beginning, Muhammad Ali's career was marred by controversy, and who knows, it may have ended last Saturday in the very same way. From the beginning, he appeared...
First, we didn't know exactly what this was, but we've developed a theory. We feel that when citizens in your society were guilty of a crime against the state, they were forced to watch this.
Remember the way it began? March of 1964. That's where it really began.
Yes, that's exactly what that was.
Thank you. Come on, little dog. Show the folks. Folks, this is it. See what God has done. There it is. Living proof. It's happened before your very eyes. God has done a miracle. God is in his place tonight. God has worked through his servant and done something wonderful again. Now I want you to get out your dollars, and we're going to give money tonight to kill a commie for Jesus. We're going to fight communism so the little dogs like this can be set free. Everyone, get out your money. Come on, get it out, children. Hallelujah. I feel good. Hallelujah.
Every now and then, I guess we all think realistically,
yes, sir,
about that day when we will be victimized with what is life's final common denominator. That's something that we call death. We all think about it, and every now and then I think about my own death, and I think about my own funeral, and I don't think of it in a morbid sense. Every now and then I ask myself, what is it that I would want said? And I leave the word to you this morning. If any of you are around when I have to meet my day, I don't want a long funeral. And if you get somebody to deliver the eulogy, tell